I have been late, you know.
Really? Good
big
for you.
Big time.
Big time, huh?
I went on a date last week.
How'd it go?
It was good.
You going out again?
I don't know.
Why not?
I haven't called her.
Christ, you're an amateur.
I know what I'm doing. Yeah. Don't worry about me. I know what I'm doing. Yeah, but this girl is, like, you know, beautiful. She's smart. She's fun. It's different from most of the girls I've been with.
So call her up, Romeo.
Why? So I can realize she's not that smart, that she's fucking boring? You know, I mean, you don't... This girl's, like, fucking perfect right now. I don't want to ruin that.
Maybe you're perfect right now. Maybe you don't want to ruin that.
I love you.
I know.
I think I must have misread all of those signals.
I guess you did.
Well, that's what we do. We fight. You tell me when I'm being an arrogant son of a bitch, and I tell you when you're being a pain in the ass, which you are 99% of the time. I'm not afraid to hurt your feelings. They have like a 2-second rebound rate, and you're back doing the next pain in the ass thing.
Go away from my window, leave at your own chosen speed. I'm not the one you want, babe. I'm not the one you need. You say you're looking for someone who's never weak, but always strong, to protect you and defend you, whether you are right or wrong. Someone to open each and every door, but it ain't me, babe. Now, 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 it ain't me, babe. It ain't me you're looking for, babe. Go lightly from the ledge, babe. Go lightly on the ground. I'm not the one you want, babe. I'll only let you down. You say you're looking for someone who'll promise never to part. Someone to close his eyes for you. Someone to close his heart. Someone to die for you and more. But it ain't me, babe. Now, 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 it ain't me, babe. It ain't me you're looking for, babe. You say you're looking for someone to pick you up each time you fall. To gather flowers constantly and to come each time you call. And we'll love you for your life and nothing more. But it ain't me, babe. Now, 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 it ain't me, babe. It ain't me you're looking for, babe.
So do you like Cuban food?
Jim, seriously, that was not code for I wish you'd try harder.
Are you always so shut down and afraid that the right man might make you feel
like a natural woman? Sorry I'm late, honey. I couldn't get a cab. How was the meeting?
Oh, well, there was a beginning, a middle, and an end. Nice to meet you, Chip.
Thank you. Whenever I get gloomy with the state of the world, I think about the arrivals gate at Heathrow Airport. General opinion's starting to make out that we live in a world of hatred and greed. But I don't see that. Seems to me that love is everywhere. Often it's not particularly dignified or newsworthy, but it's always there. Fathers and sons, mothers and daughters, husbands and wives, boyfriends, girlfriends, old friends. When the planes hit the Twin Towers, as far as I know, none of the phone calls from the people on board were messages of hate or revenge. They were all messages of love. If you look for it, I've got a sneaky feeling you'll find that love actually is all around.
Yes, yes, you're saving the world. I heard you the first time, but Ged is also saving Earthsea, and he's about to confront the Shadows, so this is Susie signing off.
Wait. Okay.
Shit.
Turn around. Look at what you see in her face.
The mirror of your dreams.
Fantasy.
Smith, don't you come here and mess up my rice again, mate.
Of course you don't, John. I had the same bloody trouble about two nights ago.
Yeah.
I come in about 11:30 at night. We've been having a couple of drinks, I remember. I come in, I get into bed, you see, feeling quite sleepy. I can feel the lids of my eyes beginning to droop, you see, a bit of the droop in the eyes. I was just about to drop off when suddenly, tap, tap, tap at the bloody window pane. I looked out, you know who it was?
Who?
Bloody Greta Garbo. Bloody Greta Garbo. Stark naked. Save for a shorty nighty. She was hanging onto the windowsill. And I could see her knuckles all white. She's saying, Peter, Peter, Hans Neuen, in the Neuen, in the. You know how these bloody Swedes go on. I said, get out of it, bloody Greta Garbo. She wouldn't go, she wouldn't go. I had to smash her down with a broomstick. Poke her off the windowsill. She fell down onto the pavement with a great crash.
She had a nightie on, is that all?
That's all she had on, Dad. Just a...
See-through?
A see-through, shorty nightie.
Yeah,
nothing else.
Yeah.
Except for her dark glasses, of course.
I weigh the water, I feel it all. I ask myself a million questions in the dark. I lay in silence, but silence talks. It tells me heaven is no closer than it was. My heart keeps pulling in the wrong direction. I'm about to cross that line, looking for the wrong affection night after night. Trying to find a new distraction, only making this all night. Everything that I've been mixing, all mixed up.
here.
I'm going to my cave. I'm going to my cave. I'm going to find my power animal.
No! Don't deal with it the way those dead people do. Come on!
I get the point, okay?
No,
please.
What you're feeling is premature and light. It's the greatest moment of your life, man. And you're off somewhere.
I'm fighting a battle. I'm fighting my shadow. Hurt fears like the cattle. I'm fighting.
The past is haunted.